Hello and welcome to the part two of this webinar titled How to Write and Sell Your Grasshopper Farming eBooks Online. In the first part of this webinar, I taught you how to gather materials for your ebook. I taught you how to write your ebook. I also taught you how to package your ebook. And I believe you must have used the knowledge you got in that part one accordingly. In this second part, I'm going to be showing you how to market that ebook which you've written by setting up a funnel, registering and hosting a website, setting up your funnel, and then I'm also going to show you how to drive traffic to your funnel to be able to get customers to buy your Grasshopper Farming ebooks. Okay, let's proceed. We'll start with how to set up your funnel. If you're wondering what a funnel is, I want you to imagine a real life funnel. With a real life funnel, you pour something in the top on into the funnel from the top, and it goes down to one destination, that is the gallon or the container, whatever it is that you're using to collect what is coming from the funnel. So also is your typical sales funnel. And your typical sales funnel is simply the journey that your ideal customer goes through before he or she becomes your buying customer. And this journey consists of all the things he encounters in terms of being aware of your product, having interest in the product, and then proceeding to purchase that particular product. This is the sales funnel. And for this sales funnel, to build a sales funnel for your ebook, your Grasshopper Farming ebook, we are going to need to register, we are going to need to have a landing page. A landing page, we are going to need to have an autoresponder. These are the two things we basically need. A landing page and an autoresponder. Every other thing we need is inside these two things, the landing page and autoresponder. And in this particular, in this second part, I'm going to show you how to set, how to register and host a website, even if you are in your bedroom. So let's proceed with that. Now we're going to register and host a website. I'll show you how to register and host a website, which you can use to set up a landing page, to design, to set up a funnel for your Grasshopper Farming ebooks, which consists of a landing page and a download page. Okay, so to register a website for to register and host a website for your Grasshopper Farming ebook, you need to choose a name, a good name that is compelling enough. You can use the name of the book which you are writing. Okay, you can use the name of the book which you are writing, which you wrote, to register the site. So how do you do that? Let me show you how you can register a website from your bedroom. And for this, we're going to be using two web hosts in Nigeria. I'm going to show you how to do that. Okay. Let me show you how to register and host a website. For this particular training, I'm going to use SmartWeb. So we'll go to SmartWeb. By now you must have conceived the name of your website. So what we'll do first is we'll check out the name of that website and see if it's available or not. If it's available, then you go ahead and register it. Okay. So here, you come here, so you can register a site for as low as a .com site for 4,800 or 9,800 for 1 year. You can imagine that. Can you imagine just having a space online, it will just cost you 4,800, 1,100 for .com.ng, 9,009 for .ng, .org, 6,000 naira, .biz, 8,200, .online, 1,300. Okay, so let's search for... Let's assume your Grasshopper Farming ebook title is Let's say, sorry, grasshopper. Okay, let's say grasshopper farming master. Let's call. So let's check if this particular site is available. So you search for domain. Okay. For the purpose of this video, I'm not going to register any site. I'm just showing you how it's done. It's a very simple thing to do. Just search for the name of the website you intend to use. If the name of the site you intend to use has been used already, the site will notify you. If it hasn't, they will tell you it's available. So let's see if this one is available. Please enter the code shown below. What do you mean? Okay, let's see. For UGC. Okay, so that's performing mastery is available. You see? So all I need to do now is to add it to cart. This is simply the step you can use to register a website. Register and host a website. What we are doing now is registering the site, the domain name, is what you are trying to do now. Okay, so I add to cart and I check out. So whilst checking out, they will now ask you, do you need hosting? And they now choose hosting. Okay, see, that is DNS is free. If you want ID protection, is 18 for 1 year. And add to cart, email forwarding, you can add to cart if you need that. It says no hosting, click to add hosting. So we now have the site name and the hosting. So let's add hosting. I'm not going to register, I'm not going to go through the process. When it gets to payment, of course. So this is the standard hosting package, 609 per month, 450 per month, super package, business package, 909 per month. You can imagine how cheap it is to own an online space. I don't know if you're getting what I'm trying to pass across to you. How much do you think a shop is worth at Alaba? How much do you think a shop is worth at Main Market? How much do you think a shop is worth at is worth in all these high-priced locations? They run into hundreds of thousands of naira, if not millions. But for as low as 600 naira a month, you can host your website online and reach virtually everybody you want to reach, as long as you target them. I don't know if you're getting the idea. It's cheaper to rent a space online than to rent a space offline. So check it out. So this is what you do. You register and you add the hosting to this package. Okay. So that is what you do. So let's see. Let me go through the process. Linux hosting. So you can use Smart Web, you can use Google Host, you can use qservers.net. Okay, so he's telling me to use the web. Yes, use to register your site. So with this process now, once we make payment, they will send us the login details of our cPanel. The cPanel simply means the control panel, that is the back door of our website through which we can enter into our website and do modifications and configurations and updates. I hope you're getting me. So, other summary. So, continue. Another site you can use, like I said, is QServer. So, here we are. Registering and hosting a website. How many minutes I think taking me to do this. I don't think it's up to 5 minutes. Okay, so review and check out. Now you see, with this, I've ordered a standard Linux hosting for this. Blue website builder for free and domain registration. So for registration and hosting, I've actually done this. So the moment I click on checkout now, for 5,400, my site will be hosted online. As simple as that. Okay? So we'll check out. So this is how to register your website and host it. This is the personal information for me to check out. And I don't need to do this, okay? So you can now try it out. First of all, go on this particular site and search for any of the websites you want to register and see if it's available. If it's available, you add a hosting to it and then you proceed. Just take time and read through it and you'll see a lot of things you can add to your registration and hosting. Another site you can try is qservers.net. Okay. Something like this. Let's see. As low as 5,000 per year. As 500 per month to register a website. You see how amazing it is. So you can go to either of these sites and do what? Search for the site name you want to use and then proceed to register it and then host it. So that is it for registering and hosting a website. So now let us assume I have registered a website for my gas water farming ebook and I have titled it chenedenuwa.com. I have a site already that I use to run these things. So that is it for registering and hosting a website. So registering and hosting a website. So let's set up our funnel for the book. To do this, you simply come to our site. So once you are done with registering and hosting your site, the company will send you your registration details to log into your cPanel via your email or the client section, the client area of that site you bought that hosting and registration from. So from there you can now log into your cPanel, and from your cPanel you now upload your CMS, which is a content management software. That is the software you use to manage content on the site. It can be WordPress, it can be Tableau, it can be Blogger, and some other CMSs. But for me, I prefer WordPress. So let's assume that your site is not set up. So this is my WordPress dashboard. What I want to do now is to set up. What I need now is to build for this funnel. We're going to be using a two-page funnel. A two-page funnel simply means a funnel that has two pages. The landing page, that is where the customer, the proposed customer, the potential customer lands on first. He clicks on your ad, the link to your ad or your image link. The moment he clicks on it, he lands on the landing page. That landing page, when he keys in his purchase details for the book, he wants to buy the book. Once he keys in his details, he will now be sent to the download page where he will now download the ebook. So we are building a two-page funnel. Okay, we have the landing page and we have the download page, the thank you page, also serve as a download page. So for building out these pages, we're going to use a page builder, and for this particular training I'm going to be using a page builder called Thrive Architect. Thrive Architect is a wonderful page builder. You need to try it out. Okay, so let's call on Thrive. Thrive dashboard. So this is my Thrive Architect plugin which I use to create and manage my pages on this site. Okay, so let us create a new page. Our first page, which is our landing page. So add new. Okay, first thing we do is we name our page. Let's name it GC Farming Mastery. Okay, let's say GC Farming ebook. That's the name of this page. So I hit on publish. Publish. Don't worry, the page is not going to be like this. This is the first thing you do. Then you go to, you go back to that dashboard. What you're going to do now? What you're going to do now is to edit that page you just created. GC Farming ebook with Thrive Architect. Okay. The beautiful thing about Thrive is that Thrive Architect already has some templates that you can borrow and use to create, build out your page. So instead of building a page from scratch, I'm going to be looking for, an already made template. If I don't find any good one that I like, I can simply create out mine. Okay? So before you do this, you must have had your content. The content you're going to put on this page must have had it all spelled out, written out. Okay? You must have had it written out. So this is how you design your page. After creating the page, you now edit it with Thrive Architect. So to do this, I'm now editing. Let me change this template that you're seeing here now, this template. So to edit it, I come to change template. Okay, so here are some of the templates that Thrive Architect has that you can borrow from. Okay. So let's look for one. So you see ebook templates. See? Ebook smart lead generation page. Ebook smart confirmation page with upsell. This ebook smart confirmation page, download page, ebook smart blog page. Let's see what this one looks like. Okay, so this is what this template looks like. Now let's preview it and see how it looks. Okay, so you see, so what you need to do is to simply upload your ebook here. That if you want to use this template and put in your content. Okay, see, this is the work form. Testimonials and the rest. But for me personally, I like to use my sales page, my landing page for selling my books. I like it to be a form of an educative content in the sense that I don't like designing it like this. I like it to be like a post at the end. That's my landing page at the end. Now I'll now insert the payment page link so that once you click on it, you land on the page, and from the page you now land on the thank you and download page. So let me show you one of my an example of what I just told you now. Okay. GC for VCPs, am I correct? Let's see. Awesome. So you see this page. So once you click on that link, this is my landing page. New book reveals how to successfully breed, carefully handle, and profitably make lots of money selling grass cotton. Written by Chinede Lohan on 5th May 2020. Read 21,035 times. See buttons to share. This is my image. And this is my text. Dear friend, if you would like to become the type of person that consistently breeds grass cutters, successfully handles them, and makes a lot of money profitably selling them, then I have good news for you. You see, about 8 years ago, I discovered a powerful truth. So this is my content, my sales letter in form of a post. So at the end, and I'll give you the buy link. So once you click on this link now, you land on my payment page, and I'm using PayStack to do that. So you land on my payment page, you see, to make payment. Are you following me? So once you click on this link, you land on this page. You can set up this page using PayStack. This is my PayStack account. You see? This is my PayStack account. You come to PayStack here and you set up these things. You can see payments. Oh. So you can see, you see my payment page, you see the payments I've been able to collect, you see them, you see some of them using this pay link. So here it is. So this funnel is just a two page funnel, a three page funnel. The first page, the landing page, the payment page, and the download page. And the download page is let me show you the download page. So the download page is like this. So once he or she lands on the landing page. Come on. Okay, once he or she lands on the landing page and goes through my landing page, and he or she is interested in buying, okay, and he or she hits the buy button, the buy button takes them to my PayStack page. Yeah, buy button takes them to the PayStack page here. And once they are through with filling in these details and they click this pay now button, they will be debited the exact amount they keyed in, and then they will be presented to a download page where they will now be able to download the things they paid for. So let's assume that after that, this is where the page they will land, where they are to, which we call a thank you page, and also and can also serve as a download page. So you have the landing page, the payment page, and the thank you page. A three-page funnel, not a two-page funnel, rather. A three-page funnel. The landing page, which is this. The landing page, the payment page, and the download page. So this is basically all you need to do to set up your funnel. So first thing is to register and host a website, which we've done using Smart Web and the Q servers. You can go to any of those sites and purchase your hosting and your registration. Then once you're done, you set up a funnel, which we've also done using a three-page funnel. Okay, landing page, payment page, and the download page. So this is the three-page funnel that I'm using to market my ebook. A three-page funnel. So funnel one, the buyer comes in from wherever he comes in, from Facebook, from YouTube, from Google, from Twitter, and he or she lands on the landing page. He or she goes through the contents of the landing page. Once they are done, they click on the buy now button for those who are interested, and it takes them to the payment page where they make their payment. Once the payment is made, the download page, the thank you page, and the download page pops up where they simply download what they have paid for. So that is how you set up your page. So how then do you drive traffic to this funnel that we've created? How do you drive traffic to this funnel that we have created? To drive traffic to this funnel we have created, you can use pre-orders. By pre-orders, you can get people to pre-order this book, your ebook, before the launch date. Okay? So by telling people you are running a pre-order campaign where they get XYZ discount for buying this book before the launch date, it will actually help to drive people to the landing page. Okay? Another way is through a Dream 100 traffic. Dream 100 traffic was popularized by Russell Brunson. Not really Russell Brunson, but he learned it from Chet, one of his marketing buddies. Okay? It's a system whereby you locate people who already have the traffic you are looking for online. There are people who your dream customers are congregating around at this moment. The idea is for you to reflect on who and who is your dream 100 traffic. Who are those that are controlling a larger amount of the traffic you need, and where are they? You need to reflect them, because the beautiful thing about getting these people is that, imagine you having been in contact with somebody who has, like, say 200,000 intending and practicing fish farmers. He has the contacts. They know, they like, and they trust him, of 200,000 intending catfish farmers and practicing fish farmers. Imagine where such a person recommends your catfish hatchery book to his or her audience. Imagine if 10% of that 200,000 buy that book within the first 3 months of promoting it. That is massive. 10% of 200,000 is 20,000. Now imagine where you have 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 100 traffic who have this bulk amount of audience with them. So you need to locate them, and you need to make them offers for them to place your product in front of their audience. By so doing, you rake up massive amount of traffic and sales. Another way to drive traffic to your funnel is through Facebook traffic. You can locate people who have groups, talk to them, If you are able to get them to help you promote your book to their audience, a win-win situation. You can also go one step further by using paid traffic on Facebook. You can pay Facebook to advertise your book so that they can simply send you traffic to your landing page, to your funnel. Okay? You can use paid traffic, or you can simply do it by yourself. Promote it on your assets, your Facebook status, your Facebook stories, your Facebook stories, promote it to the group you manage and on your timeline. These are ways you can drive traffic through Facebook to your funnel. You can also use YouTube traffic, okay? You can apply YouTube SEO and SEM marketing and use it to drive traffic to your funnel. You can also go the way of paid traffic on YouTube. You can advertise on YouTube. The beautiful thing about YouTube is because YouTube is more, the people going to YouTube are more intentional than those going to Facebook. Those going to Facebook actually go there not to look for information, or they go there primarily to connect with their friends and their families and to scroll through. But people who go to YouTube, they go to YouTube to search out information. They go to search how to clean a snail pen, how to stock your rabbits when they first arrive your farm, okay? How to hash fingerlings, okay? They are intentional when they go there. So you can also adopt YouTube traffic, pay YouTube for them to run ads to your funnel, to send traffic for you to your funnel. And you can do that through Google traffic too, and YouTube traffic. You can apply paid traffic for these two from one particular platform, and that is Google Ads. Google Ads is where you can run YouTube traffic and Google traffic. By Google traffic, it's more intentional too, because people who go to Google, they go to Google to search. Are you getting the idea? It is search oriented. Unlike Facebook, that is networking oriented, or the social media that I'm talking oriented, why search engines are search oriented. Google, YouTube, people go there to search how to's. Okay? So by paying YouTube to list, to advertise your ebook at the first result, okay, is the idea. You get YouTube, you pay Google, and when people search for, say, how to breed pigs in Nigeria, and Google gives you a result. The idea is for Google to place your ad here on the first result. It will be written ad. Okay? That's the idea. The idea is that on this search result, your result comes first. That is what we're talking about. Something like, let's say, email marketing. Let me show you what I mean. If you add, this is an advertisement. So the idea is when you advertise your product, when somebody searches for your keyword here, Google shows him your results first. And from my experience, people rarely, except the person is doing a deep research, people rarely go to the second page of Google. They rarely go across the third page self of Google. So the idea is for you to use Google homepage to drive traffic to that site, so that once they see it and they click, they land on our site, on your funnel. So that is the idea of driving traffic to your site. I hope I've been able to show you how to register and host a website. I hope I've also been able to show you how to set up your funnel. We actually set up a three-page funnel. We set up a three-page funnel using a landing page, a payments page, and a thank you page, which also serves as a download page for us. I hope you will be able to learn that. And we also discussed how to drive traffic to your funnel. I told you can also utilize pre-orders, and also utilize the 100 traffic. You can utilize Facebook traffic. You can also utilize paid traffic on Facebook by paying Facebook to send you traffic. You can also pay YouTube or keep uploading your videos or your channels and inviting people to see your books or whatever it is you're advertising. You can also pay Google to advertise your funnel on their page to drive massive amounts of traffic to your page. I hope that I've been able to help you, show you how to successfully write, package, and profitably market your Grasscutter Farming ebooks. In case you have any questions from these two webinars, part one and part two. Part one talks about how to write and package the book, and part two talks about how to set up, how to register, host a website for the book, and then set up a funnel and drive traffic to that funnel. I hope this thing has been valuable to you. In case you have any questions, please do not forget to let me know. Ask any questions you have. No question is stupid. Anything you don't understand, kindly let me know. If you're watching this video on YouTube, please subscribe and like this video. Subscribe to my channel so that you get future notifications when I post more awesome videos like this. If you're watching this on Facebook, please like and share with your friends. If you're also watching on YouTube, please share this video to your friends and family so that more people will get to see this. Okay? If you're watching on the webinar, good to have you here. Thank you very much for joining me. I really appreciate bringing your questions, and I'll gladly answer them for you. Thank you very much, and cheers.